my biggest fear is like I'm on this earth and all I'm doing is just consuming and just not be able to contribute to it getting any better. I was born and raised in New York, and I didn't start rock climbing until I was already in college. A lot of the people I was climbing with in the gym who were more experienced said, hey, come on outside. And I got introduced to the outdoors like that. That was really the first time that I spent any time in what people would call the great outdoors. You know, before then I never hiked, I never camped, I never did any of that stuff outdoors. Once I discovered it, I wanted everyone to do it. But nobody really wanted to go because I don't think people understood it. When I got started, everybody would say, oh, rock climbing, that's for white people. And sure enough, I mean, there were a lot of white people rock climbing, but for me, I grew up in Queens that was always diverse. So for me, I never felt totally out of place because of race. I just wish that we did a better job exposing the community to these outlets. Brothers of Climbing, we started it in 2012 when, you know, we were going to the climbing gym every day for 4 years, and I could still count all the people of color on one hand. All right, I see it. A bunch of friends and I, we started doing these monthly meetups, and the whole idea was we would be the guides for people of color in the rock climbing gym. We really didn't have that representation, and anytime I saw somebody that looked like me walk into the gym, I wanted them to feel good and make them feel like they were welcome there. I think the biggest problem in the world right now is that people don't understand each other. And even worse, they don't care to try and understand. I feel like a lot of the biases that we have towards each other is just because we never took the time to actually see, like, are they really like this? Is this really how the world is? And we come up with these preconceived notions in our head. And because of that, you know, we never really work together on all the issues that we need to work on. Another thing that triggered us to do this was the rock climbing gym was down the road from housing projects that are mostly people of color. And not a single one of them ever stepped into the doors of that gym. And so we wanted to do some outreach in the community to get people in. I think the rock climbing gyms, they're super expensive. So, you know, if you're a parent and you have to think, okay, I need some school clothes for my kid, that's gonna cost $50, and then a day pass for a rock climbing gym that's gonna last you, you know, a couple of hours, that's $38, plus the shoes, it's gonna be another $10. Plus, if you need instruction, that's gonna be another $100 or so. I feel like the community, it's kind of hard to justify the cost because they don't really know the benefits of it. I feel like the best way to communicate the power of the healing properties of the outdoors to communities is really to just get them the experience.
We're here, we made it.
That's why I'm a huge believer in like hosting events and things that get people in the outdoors to at the very least try it, because I feel like a lot of people shy away from what they call the great outdoors because they just don't know what to expect, right?
Try and work your feet up a little bit. Yeah. Until you feel comfortable, but you can get
everybody has this fear of the unknown, and you're afraid to step into it and fail and try and do it. And I feel like they've always had that because we didn't grow up with this sort of stuff. And, you know, maybe there's some fear or something that happened in the past that makes them feel like they don't belong out there.
Come on, keep fighting.
Come on, girl, you're almost
keep
there.
On fighting. Keep on
but pushing. Once they have this experience, now the whole thing changes for them. And now they see that they can do it. I feel like we all just want to feel understood and welcome. It's important to have that in the outdoors because, you know, when you see your community, you see yourself, right? If I go and I see this community that represents me, now I'm gonna do what I need to do in the outdoors to make sure that it's there for the rest of my community. Because once something becomes real, once something becomes tangible, then you can think about the benefits. When you're in the outdoors, you're just a little speck in there. It just really gives a broader perspective into like where we are on this earth. And I feel like it humbles us. That humbling brings us back to, you know, why we should just appreciate the life that we have. And I feel like that's something nature can do.